Hi, I'm Pawel, I make games, and I'm gonna show you how to create a scriptable object in Unity. We are going to create one to store animation frames and a gap between them. The base for our scriptable object will be a regular C# script, so let's create one and let's name it animation data, for example. Here we won't need any of these two functions we've got at the beginning, and we will need to change monobehavior to scriptable object. This is a class which animation data inherits from. Long story short, now we are using a different set of base methods provided by Unity. It also changes the way how Unity treats this element, but don't worry, you will see everything in a moment. Alright, so first thing our animation data needs is a public array of sprites. And let's call it sprites. Animations will simply change the sprite we display with a sprite renderer and wait a given constant amount of time. That's why we will need a frames of gap variable to tell how long do we need to wait before showing the next animation frame. Now let's divide 1 second by 60 frames to find out how long on average is one frame displayed on the screen. Now let's store this information in a public static float called target frame time. And we don't need to be so precise, so let's round it. In the future we're gonna multiply this value by frames of gap to get a wait time in seconds between our animation frames. We did that for our comfort only because I guess it's easier for everyone to write the number of frames instead of fractions of seconds. Now we need to do something to be able to see this animation data object in the create menu. Above the name of the class, we will need to create asset menu and set a file name to, let's say, animation data, because that's quite descriptive. And as a menu name, we will use a scriptable objects folder / animation data. And for the order, let's set it to 1 to see it on the top. And ladies and gentlemen, now as we open up a create menu, we can see our scriptable objects. So let's create one and let's see what we have. Let's name it player walk and let's create one more. This time it will be player idle. And before we finish, let's open this sprite sheet and let's click this little padlock icon to lock this window. Now we can click and select those sprites and the window won't change. Let's select the sprites from the number 5 to 11 and let's put them into sprites array. And let's add sprite number 4 at the end. Set frames of gap to 15 and that way we are ready to animate this, but this is for the next video. I hope this one was useful for you and you had some fun. It would be great if you rate this video and answer my question in the comments section. Have a good day and see you soon!